Hello, everyone, and welcome to our first workshop for National Indigenous History Month. I'm so excited that you're all here to join us. As you can see, there's a chat right there. If you have questions for Darlene, you can start putting them there as soon as possible. My name's Carly, and I'm from Jupe School. My pronouns are she and her. I'm a Caucasian woman with long, sort of crazy dark hair. I'm wearing a gray t-shirt and brown glasses. And I'm seated in my bedroom slash office. So behind me is a window with some plants, my bed, and a bookshelf.
Hi, everyone. My name is Luke Tellier. My pronouns are he, him, or they, them. I also work at Jupe School as an artist and facilitator. I'm a Caucasian person with a pink ball cap on my head and a blue sweater that says practice radical empathy. And I'm sitting in my office with a beautiful armchair behind me. Before we dive in, I want to say that the Jubilee Auditoria are located on Amiskwichi, Waskahegan, and Mokinstis, which are colonially known as Edmonton and Calgary, on Treaty Territories 6 and 7. These lands have been and continue to be home to the First Nations, Métis, and many other Indigenous peoples, both recorded and unrecorded. And while we're excited to be celebrating National Indigenous History Month with you, we also want to acknowledge the memory of the residential school victims from across the country. We stand in solidarity with the survivors and their families and mourn those we have lost. With that in mind, we are very excited and grateful to welcome the wonderful Darlene Pearl Auger to be sharing her story with us today, My Belly Button. Welcome, Darlene. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here. So my name is Darlene Auger, and I come from a northern community called Wabaska originally, but I have been living in Edmonton for a long, long time. And this is where I currently reside. I am she, her. And I am wearing a moose hide dress with shells and beading on it. And I have feathers in my hair. My hair is up in a bun. And I have a drum behind me. And yeah, I'm excited to be here. I am going to just share a little bit with you about how I came to write these children's books. It wasn't that, you know, I knew that I wanted to be an author or anything like that. I actually really never thought I would be an author. But what happened for me, I was studying my psychology degree, and in 2001, just before I graduated, I had a very powerful spiritual vision that kind of took me in a different direction. And so in my vision, I was shown a very large baby swing, we call them in our communities. It's like a cradle hammock that swings in a lateral motion. And we put our babies in there to rock them to sleep. But what I saw was a really, really large one. And there was an adult in there wrapped up like a little baby. Now, this was at the very first Indian residential school healing gathering, way before even TRC came to be. And so in my vision, I was told by an old woman, a grandmother spirit, that the people needed to be swung. And so after that, just to make a very long, long story short, I went to the bush to fast for 4 days without food and water to try to come to an understanding of what the grandmother spirit wanted me to do. And so there I was given a lot of knowledge and given a lot of strength, emotional, mental, spiritual, and physical strength to do this, to live out this vision. And so it happened. And for the last 20 years, I have been swinging people for health. And so now it's become well known as a holistic healing practice. And I practice here in Edmonton out of my home, but I also travel all over. I've been all over. I've been so fortunate to be also in several different parts of the world, bringing my swing healing to other people. And so I ended up going back to school in 2012 to do a doctorate degree in Indigenous life knowledge in education. And what I wanted to know was, I wanted to do more research on the healing swing. And while I was doing my research there, I realized at some point that what I really wanted to do was I wanted to leave the teachings behind for the little ones. And how can I do this for them? And so what I did was I developed a little kit, and it's called the Little Woman's Lodge Kit. And there's two different Little Woman's Lodge kits. One is held by my publisher, and the other one I keep because it's a community effort. There's other women in the community that helped me create this little kit. And basically it comes with a little 5-foot teepee. And inside the teepee, it has a little swing. And inside this little swing, there's a baby doll in a moss bag. And then it has the four little books that I have on the teachings of the belly button, the teachings of the teepee, the teachings of the moss bag, and the teachings of the swing. And so those four little books. And I also had developed a CD of Cree lullabies. And this was, again, a community collaboration. So several women, Cree women, came together and we went in search through our family history of our Cree lullabies. And we thought, let's record them before we lose them. And so that's what we did. And we created this CD that also comes with the kit. And then my publisher was really interested in creating an audio for the books so that people could hear me reading the stories in Cree, in the language. So my language is Woodland Cree, or Sagaw Nihio. And so you can hear me reading the stories in Cree and in English in this audio. So it comes with all of those pieces, the kit, and that's the kit that I kind of look after. And then the kit that my publisher looks after is the 5 books, the audio, the CD of lullabies, and my beautiful daughter, who's now a teacher, a grade 3 teacher, her and I developed a teacher's guide to go with the books and the audio and CD. Yeah. So that's what I did, because I do have, I guess my first formal education was in early childhood development. And I do know that children learn through play. And so I wanted children, Indigenous children, to come back to an understanding of how to be Indigenous, you know, their identity, to come back into their Indigenous mind, to know that these teachings still exist and that they can practice once again the parenting methodologies that were stripped from residential school survivors and down the generations. My parents went to residential school, my grandparents and my two older siblings. I was very, very lucky that the residential school in my community closed then after that, so that I didn't have to go. And so I still speak my Cree language, and I just feel so fortunate. It's very sad what's happening today. You know, that these little children are being found, the remains of the little children. And, you know, I'm sad to say that this is just the beginning. We're going to find many, many more little, you know, remains of little children across Canada, because this is the sad, you know, dark truth of what really happened. And so we must come to, you know, an awareness and an acceptance of what happened, and rally together in support and create a different, more caring and more compassionate world for our children. And so I'm going to read my story today called Nitsi, My Belly Button. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read first in Cree, and then I'll translate in English. And after I read the story, we will have some time for questions or discussion. Nitsi. Nihiao Nia. Umahaski, Alberta. Egwa gaganatah uhtsinia. Sagawinuag egwa. Nahkawinuag niwahumaganak. I am Cree from Northern Alberta, Canada. My relatives are of the Bush Cree and Soto tribes. Higwayamaga nihio. Atiht ituywag, aywag ka nignamagit aksuin. Ego atiht ituywag, neuino kutagagmina ituywag, neuaski ino. What is a nihio? Some people say that Nihiel means the healing people, and some say it means the four-part being of the earth. Still others say the four directions people. Nihio is the term that we use to call ourselves, the Cree people, Nihio. The word Cree was actually given to us by colonizers. That isn't what we call ourselves. Kistin nitsikasun. Ayamanao tsikka kistik. Nuhtawi yigiwihit. Neogi sagalpa maisk initaugian. Guspisa igi puatat mihtsiit apsissiit kisten sahepik swatagut. Huitsemi on negawiwa. Tan sisa kisen nihio ihtat, little tornado. My name is Kisten. It means whirlwind or little tornado in Cree. My dad named me. He dreamed of little tornadoes talking to him 4 days before I was born. So he asked my mom how to say little tornado in Cree. Negawi guitimio nohkom apaksisa. Igom sisisa itu nohkom. Ayan na managa kiste. Mihi itu negawi. Ma. Kiste nitte kwe. Itu isa. Nohkom apaksis. Negawi guitamuio nohtawiwa. Igom sisi isa itu nohtawi. Iksisa. Gawi isih kasut. Ipipim no. Ikse dakwe. My mom then asked my grandma mouse. Grandma mouse said, oh, you mean when there is a big whirling wind? And my mom said, yes. And my grandma said, Kisten, I guess. So my mom told my dad, and my dad said, that will be the name of our baby. And so it is. Anocht egwa, kiwia tumustat nawao umanitsi. Today, I want to tell you a story about my belly button.
Pa mai skuta, iki pini taugian, ugawi mawaski, iki ahta kusian, egwa.
Before I came to be a baby girl here on Mother Earth, I was a spirit, and I lived in spirit world.
Igutti nigihui tsig niguimis. Nini suhka maawagan. Igwa. Nikskinuh tamagan. Nigiwih tamag. Ngagin tauwigin. Ugawi maawaskih iskawis. Kantogs na hamaksiyan.
While in spirit world, I had a special helper, a guide. She told me that I could go to the earth world to live for a while, to learn and grow.
Ninuhti tuhtan. Ikse. Nto apihigon. Isimuyapi wipsunik. Iguta. Uhtse. Ninawasu nao isku. Taugawian. Iguanapio. Tauhtawian.
I wanted to go. So I was placed on the rainbow swing to choose a young woman
that I would need to be my earth mother, and a young man that I would need to be my earth father. Nigisksin mana, Eguanma bisamiapi wipsun, Igi. Iki we tap mago e botanit sanak. Iki pihuyak isko kakise wawito nigihikwag. Egotakwayats nipi nihdaugin aski. Wahwa nip tapahtemon. I remember sitting on that rainbow swing with my brothers and my sisters. We were all waiting for the day when everything would be ready for us to be born to the earth as human babies. I was so humbled. Nigawi watak nigi pitah konek eguta nigi oh pekin gigam tah pisim maske motih gigi asuasuyan apsiskwe simon ahpuah tah kagoh pisih kati gigwanma nipi ah tah Nigi weep dik dahtuki sigal. Nigisk sumik bisimiapi weep sun. Nigi mi oyan igwanigi sosin. Namuya nikustin. When I made my journey to the earth world, I came through the tummy of my chosen earth mummy. She held me in her belly for 9 months while I grew. I was in a bag full of warm water. The bag is called a pillow or a spirit blanket in Cree, or the placenta in English. The water spirit rocked me every day, which reminded me of the rainbow swing. I was comfortable and warm, and I was not scared at all. Eguakani taugian, nohtawi nikiosihtamag wipsun. Egutta, eguane wipsun. Esko egaskihtayan, tampimtatsumuyan. Then, when I was born, my father made me a baby swing. So there too, I continued to be swung. And I was comforted until I could crawl. Nigi wihtamaga unan, daptawe. Kistame maganwag, egwa, kegwe mesa nawag, kitahtah kunawag, kawitihe kunawag, uta, me gwawi kiahke aski. Tapskot mina nema, kikawi ma utsiapi, kapi, pematsehe kweyak, Daptawe gamusahano, kitahtahuno, iwe tsehkuyak. Katah gamusahano, big squatiguyake. We were told that throughout our earth life journey, we would always be connected to our spirit and to our ancestors in spirit world. This connection is like that of the umbilical cord that connects the fetus to the mother through the belly button. The spiritual connection cannot be seen, but it can be felt through the belly button and is most often referred to as a gut feeling or an intuition. Gami guapi biswea. No what I walk kemusehano getahtahuno. Magi gua katuh pigiach. Kitate wangisksano. Usam wau yak mstaheki kwai. Ke wan sihikuno o mutaski. When we are small, we understand and we feel our connection to spirit world clearly. However, as we grow up, we start to lose that connection because the earth world is so full of distractions and we forget. Ascomi namana, kita teta puhtino, ngakiano, iyo tahtahuya. Ego tapskut, ngaki guayahtahuanihtagwa, namoy miyasinuma. Wea, iwahkumayahkwal, kinstame maganwag. Ego ay gutaw, tsimana, mina. Kikskehte no kiano nehiawak. I asked ki big squat no. Ki big squat wag. Negamo ne. Ki nehiaw big squeo ne. Igwa usihtigio ne. Sometimes we even start to believe that we are not of spirit and that there's no spirit world. This is sad because it is our connection to our ancestors and spirit world that keeps us strong and knowing who we are as Cree people. They speak to us through our land, our language, our songs, our ceremonies, and our dreams and visions. Eogohtanma, ganahasta. Get up square someone now, egwa get seasonal. We up go, kawi kakiwi magahqua. In a haina mech, egwa, in a naskumuyak, epimiotaguhtiahuta. That is why there is a special ceremony made for our first blanket, known as the placenta. When we are born, we no longer need the spirit blanket or the umbilical cord. They are taken and buried in clean land, offered back to Great Spirit, and we give thanks for the good and safe journey we made to the earth. Gauski pipi suyah kanagis. Iakutamu apsis ketsisano ipasti. Egua mitune wayask inagat nagati tak kegawino isko pakitike. For a little while, a small piece of the dried umbilical cord is left on our belly button. Our parents take really good care of it until it falls off on its own. Pachitike egua, kikawino aku, kukumno, kusita magono muswa pachigen, maskimuts, egota, kasuatao kitsisano, egua, kakskino, kitaugan na, isko, piago. When the umbilical cord falls off, our mom or our grandmother makes a little moose hide pouch for it. This little piece of cord is placed into the pouch and pinned to our back until we can walk on our own 2 feet. Matiga. Gaganawim kuno kitahtsa kuno o sam gati swa egi big squista masoya namoya ti swa egi asam soya pugukit sanwa kanaga temboya ke. This is done to protect us because we are still very much spirit during this time. We cannot speak, walk, or eat on our own. We need our earth family to care for us.
Kanto nainam, nanto ikanata nig askik. Kispin, kintawim kuno, kanihta matia, ekusetas tau kitsisano, op matio maskimutsik. Kispin, kintawim kuno, tamasko, tamaskihkiwiak, ekuse, utapig once. Ka tantawastaw. Wia tansisi tihtake, tamio pematihuya, ahpu tansise, taki wichihtasuya.
Once we start to walk, Daddy or Grandpa will take the little pouch out to the bush to be buried in clean ground or placed somewhere according to what our families wish for our future and well-being. For example, my dad might wish for me to be a good hunter or trapper. So he may hide my little belly button piece in a hunter's bag or a trapper's cabin. Or he may place it in the roots of the healing plants. In the bush, in the hopes that I will be a good medicine woman and help people with healing.
Taptawi kitahta kuno kawichihi kuno, egwa kamusehano, kitsinak. Our spirit connection continues to be with us and communicates with us through our belly button. Iksimana kamusihtaya katahkiwe tapskut sagutskiwe ekskitamach maganamoyak ekskitino tansisi sekskitamach eogonma katahtakuno ekiskunehtahiguyah namoywe gats gawansimkuno. You know that feeling you get in your gut when you know something, but you don't know how you know? That's your spirit telling you right from wrong, and your spirit will never, ever mislead you. Tapskutski spin, kemusihtan katak, ngay gutamiska no, kasuahaman, ntuhtaso, kaya suahay gutamiska no, kanagatim ko no, katahtsah ko no, kispin kintuhtawano. For example, if you have a gut feeling that you should not cross the road at that point, then don't cross the road at that point. Listen, and you will be protected, perhaps even saved from an accident. Taptawi ntuhtamane ay wag katemusehaw katahta na watskamaskawatsin. The more you listen and acknowledge the spirit connection and communication, the stronger and sharper it will become, and the closer you will feel to your spirit. Kitah tah kan magitotem namoywi kat kan nagatik taptawe kamiyo nagatimik. Your spirit is your best friend. It will never let you down. Trust it, believe in it, and it will always take good care of you. Eogohtimana kawihi soyan ki stin nitsih kasun nitituan. Tapskut ntahtsah ki stinih kasut. Ahputtikwi nikagituan tapskut ntahtsah kegwa ki stin papiakwan. Eogohtana kagi nihioih kasuyah ki tahtsah kuno. Then stone away that's a cook. He's a cook. Oh yeah, that's why in my Cree language, when I introduce myself, I say, Kistin Nitsikasun, which literally translates as, my belly button is acting like Kistin. Remember, Nit to see means my belly button. And kasun means to act like. So this introduction word in Cree, netsih kasun, means my spirit is acting like Kistin. That is why it's so important for us to have a spirit name so we can properly introduce our spirit self. And our spirit will be recognized in spirit world. Oma nitsi atumons. Tanuikia kitsi. This
is the story of my belly button. Where is your belly button? Ego se, the end.
Darlene, thank you so much for sharing that story with us. It just warms every part of my heart, so thank you so much. We've already had two questions for you
in
the chat on YouTube. So students and teachers, if you're watching still, please put your questions into the chat. We have about 5 minutes left, so please send them our way. The first question is, who illustrated the book? And were they digital drawings? Were they painted? Were they drawn? That's the first question.
The illustrations are by Chloe, a young girl, Chloe Mustosh. Her Cree name is Bluebird. And she is from just nearby here, Edmonton, Alexis Reserve. And she, Alexander Reserve. And she just got out of art college when we grabbed her. And she does this, all of her work digitally. Yeah.
Thank you so much. The other question is, are all of the books written in Cree and English?
Yes. All the books are written in Cree syllabics, Cree standard Roman orthography, and English.
So Cree syllabics would mean that an English speaking person could read it to their family. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
That's awesome. That's so wonderful.
Actually, if a non-Cree speaker could read the syllabics, they could actually sound it out and they'd be reading Cree.
Wow, that's so cool.
Do you write it in English or Cree first? Is a follow-up question.
That's really interesting because I do a mix of both.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, some statements, like some of the sentences or some parts of the story, come to me in Cree first, and so I'll write them in Cree and then I'll translate them in English. And then some things come to me in English first and then I translate them into Cree. So I kind of do both.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Two people just, one, Julie has said, there's so much love in this story. So thank you, Darlene. And then someone named Megan has also said, thank you for sharing this story. Oh, a grade two online question.
Okay.
This is from a grade two student. Why did you make this book?
I thought that it was really important for you, for all your friends, to know that you have a spirit that walks with you and looks after you every day, and you are never alone. That's what I wanted you to know. That's why I wrote this story. Thank you for asking.
That's so beautiful. Thank you so much. And doesn't seem like we have any other questions at this moment. But I just, again, wanted to thank you for sharing your work and your story with us. I think this is a wonderful way to kick off our National Indigenous History Month. So thank you so much for being a part of it. For those of you watching on YouTube, put the link where you can purchase Darlene's books right in the chat so you can grab them all for your classroom or your home. A grade two comment also has come in. I think this book is so nice. And I agree with you, grade two student. I think this book is so nice too. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us here on YouTube today. We have more programming coming up and your teachers will be getting emails about it. Thanks again, Darlene.
Thank you, Darlene. That was beautiful.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be with you all. I wish I could see all your beautiful faces. I can't see anybody, but I trust that you're there.
They're all there. Thank you again, everyone. Oh, wait, where can we buy the books? Oh, okay. I will email you, Ms. Coon.